How many masks do they make in a week?
¿Cuántas máscaras pueden hacer en una semana?
De las grandes podemos avanzar poco en una para hacer, pero de estas chicas tal vez hagamos unas 5 a la semana. Hacer nomás, no pintar.
Yeah, he's saying like the big ones are, it can't even finish them in a week. Depends on how complicated it is. But he was saying that those little ones, did you understand? He said 5 en la semana. What is 5?
Okay.
5 es semana.
Hay 7 días en una semana.
Días de la semana.
So 5, they can make 5 of those in a week. So that just gives you an idea, and it just depends. Those big ones, it can take him several weeks to make a big one like that. That's pretty good. Yeah.
What is the January word?
What is the what?
The January word.
Where does it go?
Oh, this giant word. That is like the kids in Mexico and Michoacán, they have to learn that, is that one of their vocabulary words. That is the name of a town in Michoacán where a very famous volcano started erupting out of nowhere, out of a cornfield. It starts coming up, and the volcano is called Paricutín. And ¿cómo se llama este pueblo?
San Juan Parangaricutirimícuaro.
You should write that down. Yes. You might get that on a quiz.
Total.
I'm not kidding either.
You know. And like.
Pero es un pueblo, ¿verdad?
Yeah.
Es un pueblo.
No, this is, yeah, it's a town in Michoacán.
Sí, es un pueblo de Michoacán.
Yeah.
Donde hay un volcán que hizo erupción ya hace como 40 años.
Yeah, it came up, I think it started in 1943, and the lava flow stopped right in front of this church altar.
Okay, no, right.
So it's kind of like a word that all kids practice saying, you know, learning their vowels, because lots of vowels in that one. Yes?
Do they have like a mask that they like to
cover as like their favorite? ¿Ustedes tienen un tipo de máscara que les gusta hacer mucho, como su estilo favorito?
Pues, el estilo favorito mío serían los búhos o tecolotes con diferentes figuras, porque tienen mucho colorido y pues uno cada vez va haciendo los diferentes.
Yeah, he likes, búho is owl, or tecolote is an indigenous word. He likes making these because they have incorporate lots of colors. He can practice his color scheme, and he can put different creatures in the owl's mouth. Last week we were at a school in Connecticut, and the art teacher actually bought one. It was an owl with an iguana in his beak. Remember, this is all one piece of wood. This one is an owl. He carved the owl first, and then he carved a piece of wood there to make it look like a snake.
I love that.
And that fits in there. And then again, so these can be, you know, a couple hundred dollars, and he makes simpler owls like this. It's a simple one. For him, simple. For us, complicated. And here's one with a skeleton on it. Yeah, the mini version. Un momento, y a ver cuál es su tipo de máscara.
Pues animales de todo tipo, ranas, venados,
He likes to make animals. Here's a venado, deer, rana, frog, other animals, tigres, right? Armadillo. All sus cuervos, he loves making his little cuervos, his little crows with a snake in his mouth.
Yeah.
With the wild boar hair. So those are kind of his favorites. Oh, chickens, gallinas. Yes.
Which do you like better, carving or painting them?
¿Cuál prefiera? ¿Hacer máscaras o pintar máscaras?
Pues todo nos gusta, y por decir así, como nosotros como hermanos, cada quien, ya en Michoacán, cada quien, máscara que empieza, tiene que terminar. Cada quien hace su propio trabajo. Y por decir así mismo, nos gusta todo el proceso.
Yeah, they like the whole process. They all learn how to carve and paint. So they usually, whoever carves, if you carve a mask, you usually get to paint it. So they're taking turns. This is our second week touring now throughout New England. So yesterday Abedo or Modesto was carving. So this gives him a day off from carving, and it gives Abedo a chance to carve. So they take turns, and then when these, this mass will stay natural in your school, because the wood has to dry and everything. And then, you know, they take turns, it gives them a break, because it takes a lot of concentration. You watch them up there. I mean, he's working with very sharp tools, so he has to be focused on that. Same thing with Modesto painting. You can see this. I mean, he's been painting this. ¿Cuántos días ya ahora pintando?
Cuatro días.
Yeah, 4 days painting these snakes. See all the detail work on that? It's amazing. 4 days just doing that. He had to take his time. And he doesn't do it like nonstop all day. He's just taking his time doing everything. Very, and that, the proportions of that are just practically perfect. Yes?
What's the hardest feature on the face to carve?
Interesting question. ¿Cuál rasgo o gesto de la cabeza o de la cara es lo más difícil de hacer?
Pues sería más que nada lo, o sea, centrar bien lo que es los ojos y la boca, que siempre nosotros medimos 4 dedos aquí a boca, 4 dedos nariz y 4 frente. O sea, es la noción de tener las medidas exactas para hacer los ojos y hacer la boca, la misma distancia.
So the hardest part is getting the right distance between the mouth, la boca, y ojos, what are ojos? Eyes. And he said he measures the face with 4 finger width. Everybody try this. 4 fingers from the bottom of your nose to your chin, right? That's pretty accurate. Then from the bottom of your nose to your eyebrows, and from your eyebrows to the top of your head. It's about equal distance. So your nose is about a third of the way up from your chin. And that's really important. The foundation, whether it's mask making or building a house or, you know, learning math or whatever thing, is very important. So they had to start out at the very beginning, making sure that nose is that, and I've seen them just take a piece of wood and measure it. And you can see like 4 fingers there, and about 4 fingers there. And that's what will start the nose. And since the nose is the part that sticks out the most, you have to leave that and scoop the wood away.
Mm-hmm. Well, how long does it take for, like, to make a mini mask?
Okay. ¿Cuánto tiempo lleva para hacer una máscara como mediana, como esta?
Mediana, tal vez un día para hacer, hasta un día.
¿Ustedes entienden inglés? ¿Entienden más que habla?
Sí.
Yeah, so they understand more English than they can speak. Probably same with you. When you're learning a new language, part of it is just getting your ears accustomed to understanding everything, and then, of course, then you gotta remember how to get the conjugation, and all that takes a little bit more time. But yeah, so about a day to carve those, esos pequeños.
Esos tal vez unos, ¿qué serán? Tal vez, de esos unos, pueden hacerse por serie unos 15 o 20, pero sin pintar.
Yeah. 15 o 20, what numbers are those? 15. How many is 15? 15 o 20?
20.
He says he can make between 15 or 20, pero sin pintar. Pintar is to paint, right? So he can make 15 or 20 just making them, not painting them. Then they dry out thoroughly, and then they paint. ¿Más preguntas?
Let's get some other questions. Any questions you might think? Yeah, maybe we can talk about what they can purchase then.
Okay, well, let's say one question we hear a lot, yeah. And this is something, and this is about cutting themselves.
Yes.
I know people, they make this look like fun,
like,
but you really don't want to go home and try this. ¿Ustedes han cortado?
Sí. Yo corté mi cortada fue... estaba rayando, un descuido, atravesé la mano, metí la ramita hasta aquí y salió aquí.
meter y salir. So it, he was carving and he slipped and it went right into his palm here and came out the other side. And he pulled it out and then he said, luckily he didn't hit any tendons, so his fingers all moved. But he had to like take a month off of carving and then just paint.
Yo también, o sea, también con esto algo parecido, fue algo también más o menos, se rompió la máscara, pero a mí nada más por fuera. Se entró aquí, salió aquí, así.
And his, he was carving with the snake and the snake broke and went in his hand right when he came out there. So it's really, really dangerous. And they say now they don't really cut themselves that much, maybe once a year. But starting out, that's the biggest thing. That's why they waited till they were like teenagers, like 16, 17 years old, working, because it's a dangerous method of carving. They're holding right onto it, and they're pushing these tools. And notice how he's carving with that tranchete. He's not just pulling it. He's actually guiding it with his thumb. And that's the one that has the pressure. He lets off the pressure, it's not going to slip. So if they're very, very careful with carving, and even they won't even let their own children do this until they're old enough and have enough confidence. They might whittle these little tiny ones, but not none of those big tools they use at all for their young men. So it's extremely...
What do we say? Muchas gracias. Gracias.
¿Podemos hacer la fiesta? Vamos a ver. See that? You see he's got all the feathers now. He's starting to delineate the feathers.
La boca ya termina con la boca.
Sí, termina con la boca.
He's going to finish the final thing the next time, probably the teeth. Isn't that amazing?
That is so cool.
You find out. See that thing?
Wow,
it's look how moist it is. It's almost done.
Oh yeah, it's so moist, isn't it?
Yeah,
so
the wood
fresh.
Is...
Yeah.
That's a nice piece.
It's beautiful. What do you think? Yeah?
Okay. Do we want to have people want to come up, take a little closer look?
Just don't touch those finger masks. Don't touch them and pick them up, okay? If you see anything you want to buy, you can buy all of them.
This is amazing.